Once upon a time, there were four little rabbits, and their names were Flopsy, Mopsy, Cottontail, and Peter. They lived with their mother in a sandbank underneath the root of a very big fir tree, and there was nothing their mother liked better than to busy herself at home, cooking and looking after her children.
My name is Mrs. Rabbit, and happy is my lot. See what beautiful children I have got. I work for them and care for them and teach them how to be most respected members of the bunny family.
We're a happy family, yes, a happy family, and we live at the foot of the big fir tree. Flopsy and Mopsy,
how could they be sweeter?
And funny little Cottontail.
And Peter, I'm naughty. I don't do as I'm told. I get into lots of trouble. I have lots of fun, though.
My name is Mrs. Rabbit. My house is underground. Friends and relations are living all around. I nod to them and smile at them and always try to be a most respected member of the bunny family.
We're a happy family, yes, a happy family, and we live at the foot of the big fir tree. Flopsy and Mopsy,
how could they be sweeter?
And funny little Cottontail.
And Peter.
Now, my dears, you may go into the fields or down the lane, but don't go into Mr. McGregor's garden. Your father had an accident there. He was put in a pie by Mrs. McGregor. Now run along and don't get into mischief. I'm going out.
Old Mrs. Rabbit took a basket and her umbrella and went through the wood to the baker's. She bought a loaf of brown bread and 5 currant buns. Flopsy, Mopsy and Cottontail, who were good little bunnies, went down the lane to gather blackberries. But Peter, who was very naughty, ran straight away to Mr. McGregor's garden and squeezed under the gate.
Oh, it is a tight squeeze. There, I'm through. Oh, look at those lettuces. I must have some of those.
The lettuce in this garden, I count my very own. And every day I come here to see what has been sown. I love McGregor's garden and watch with tender care to make quite sure that not one leaf is left to wither.
And those French beans. Delicious. And my, oh my, radishes. Oh dear, I think I've eaten too much. I must have some parsley.
Feeling rather sick, he went to look for some parsley. But round the end of the cucumber frame, whom should he meet but Mr. McGregor? Mr. McGregor was on his hands and knees planting out young cabbages. Suddenly he looked up and saw Peter.
Ah, a rabbit. He's been stealing my lettuces. Stop, thief!
He jumped up and ran after Peter, waving a rake. Peter was most dreadfully frightened. He rushed all over the garden, for he'd forgotten the way back to the gate. He lost one of his shoes among the cabbages and the other shoe amongst the potatoes.
Oh, dear, he'll catch me.
Stop, thief! He's stolen my radishes.
Oh, dear, help! He'll catch me. I'll be rabbit pie. No, I'm winning. I'm winning. I'm going to get away. Oh!
Peter had run into a gooseberry net and got caught by the large brass buttons on his new blue jacket.
Oh, dear, I'm caught now. This is the end of Peter Rabbit. I'll be rabbit pie. I hope I give him hiccups. It's all very well for you to say exert yourself. I'm all caught up in this net.
Mr. McGregor came up with a sieve, which he intended to pop upon the top of Peter. But Peter wriggled out just in time, leaving his jacket behind him.
Hooray! I'm free!
Peter rushed into the tool shed and jumped into a watering can.
Oh, dear. This would have been a beautiful thing to hide in if it had not had so much water in it. Oh, here comes Mr. McGregor.
Stop, thief, not another lettuce leaf. Will you have radishes and parsleys, carrots and baby peas? Each and everything belongs to me, not to you, but to me. If I catch you, you will die, then you'll be rabbit pie. Supper for me wife and I. away. Stop, thief! Stop, thief! I know he's in here somewhere. He's behind that brush. No, he's behind that sack of potato seed. No. Ah, he's under one of those flower pots. No. 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 No.
Good tissue.
There he is. Come here.
Mr. McGregor was after him in no time and tried to put his foot upon Peter, who jumped out of a window, upsetting three plants. The window was too small for Mr. McGregor, and he was tired of running after Peter. He went back to work. Peter sat down to rest. He was out of breath and trembling with fright, and he had not the least idea which way to go. Also, he was very damp with sitting in the watering can.
Oh, dear, I do get into some scrapes, don't I? Why do I do it? What can it be? There's naughtiness in everyone, but twice as much in me. I'd give the world if only I could now and again be good. Why do I do it? What is the cure? My brothers and my sisters find it easy, I am sure. No one believes I'd like to be good. Nevertheless, I would. I think a halo would suit me. Dangling over my head. When they behold me, they wouldn't scold me. They'd say, well done, instead. Why do I do it? Am I to blame? The others can be naughty, but it never seems the same. That's how I've been ever since I begun. Why do I do it? Why do I do it? Why do I do it? Because it's fun.
After a time, he began to wander about, going lippity-lippity, not very fast, and looking all round. He found a door in a wall, but it was locked, and there was no room for a fat little rabbit to squeeze underneath. An old mouse was running in and out over the stone doorstep, carrying peas and beans to her family in the wood.
Excuse me, Mouse. Can you tell me the way to the gate? It isn't very polite to talk with a pea in your mouth.
Peter was very upset because he couldn't understand the mouse, and he began to cry.
Come back. Oh, dear, she's gone. I'm lost. I'll try this way, straight across the garden.
Presently he came to a pond where Mr. McGregor filled his water cans. A white cat was staring at some goldfish. She sat very, very still. But now and again, the tip of her tail twitched as if it were alive.
A cat? I don't think I'll ask her the way. I've heard all about cats from my cousin Benjamin Bunny. A cat is the sort of a chap or a girl who will eat for a treat rabbit meat. It will creep, it will leap, will fake sleep, use deceit, just to eat for a treat rabbit meat. The moral is clear of cats, beware. Patter feet. Quick retreat. Life is sweet.
He went back towards the tool shed, but suddenly, quite close to him, he heard the noise of a hoe. Scritch, scratch, scratch, scritch. Peter scuttered underneath the bushes. But presently, as nothing happened, he came out and, climbing on a wheelbarrow, looked around. The first thing he saw was Mr. McGregor hoeing onions. His back was turned towards Peter, and beyond him was the gate. Peter got down very quietly off the wheelbarrow and started running as fast as he could go along a straight walk behind some blackcurrant bushes.
There's that rabbit again! Come back! Come back!
Sorry, Mr. McGregor, I can't stop just now.
Peter ran as fast as he could, slipped under the gate, and was safe at last in the wood outside the garden. Mr. McGregor hung up the little jacket and the shoes for a scarecrow to frighten the blackbirds. Peter never stopped running or looked behind him until he got home to the big fir tree. He was so tired that he flopped down upon the nice soft sand of the floor of the rabbit hole and shut his eyes. His mother was busy cooking.
Peter Rabbit, where have you been?
Who, me? Nowhere.
Dear me, what a state you're in. And where are your clothes? That's the second little jacket and pair of shoes you've lost in a fortnight.
Mummy, I don't feel very well.
I'm not a bit surprised. Come along, off to bed with you, and I'll make you some chamomile tea. 1 tablespoonful to be taken at bedtime.
Flopsy, Mopsy, and Cottontail had bread and milk and blackberries for supper. But Peter Rabbit was sent to bed.
Why do I do it? What can it be? There's naughtiness in everyone, but twice as much in me. I'd give the world